Who's the biggest diva?
There's only one winner right here. There's only one winner.
Hi guys and welcome to Uncut. Today I'm at Newcastle's training ground. I am joined by the Longstaff Brothers, Matty and Sean. How are you guys?
Yeah, good.
Two brothers playing in the Premier League, but I want to know, how well do you actually know one another? So in front of me here, I've got a list of questions. Are you confident?
Sure, well.
No, not really.
We're going to get found out we don't spend a lot of time each other away from football.
Anytime I've watched Newcastle, you just seem to pass the ball to one, but you won't pass to anyone else.
We'll try to.
Sean, we'll go first with you. The question I'm going to ask you, if your brother was to be an animal, what animal would he be? You write down your answer.
I'll go tiger.
The random close one. To be fair.
Said lion, that's not far away.
We'll give you half a point.
Half a point, I'll take that.
Right then, Matty. If your brother could have dinner with any all-time Premier League player, who would he choose?
I think it's between two.
Okay, well, he's starting to write.
It's between Gerrard or Rooney. And by them eyes, it's not. I'm going to go Paul Scholes.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, well, it shows. It shows that it's correct. Here we go, man. Here's your third one. If your brother could only watch one movie for the rest of his life, what film do you think it would be?
The Warrior.
You just said off camera that your favourite movie was Warrior.
Just so we're clear, obviously as I was introducing everything to the two lads, they did joke that his favourite film was Warrior, and Sean has written down the Harry Potter.
Well, do I need a beat here? Half a point.
No, you got one and a half.
Or one and a half.
Okay. Sean, what is your brother's proudest moment? Don't be cheating.
I'm not cheating.
You don't have to write everything though. I think anyone who watches Newcastle or supports Newcastle should surely guess this.
It has to be the goal he scored against Man United on his Premier League debut.
I would have gone for the same thing.
Actually for playing with Sean against Man United. Know what I mean? Not many brothers get to play together, so that's probably up there.
We'll give you the point for that.
It's the same thing, I'll give you that.
Playing against Man United.
Yeah.
What is your brother's biggest fear?
Give him a hint or not?
No, no hint.
No hint. I think if I'm a celeb, if I go on there, what wouldn't I want to go and touch?
Well, we said no hints.
I'd say a snake, maybe.
Correct.
Snakes.
I'm a celeb every year watching it, saying to my, couldn't do snakes.
Okay, the third question. What is your brother's worst habit?
It's not really a habit, but you're a terrible driver, to be fair, like. So it has to be something with driving, like just ragging the car around corners. That's what I'm going to say.
What did you write?
I just put laugh.
Laugh?
Yeah, I've got a pretty loud laugh in it, and it's
not too annoying though.
Well, you don't get a point for that, because obviously you went for driving, he's written down laugh. So there you have it, lads. It seems Sean knows Matty, better Matty knows Sean. I think maybe you need to spend a little more time with your older brother.
I think you do as well. That's poor for me. I'm disappointed in you, to be fair, like.
Now, guys, it's time for Team of the Week, and first up, in goal is Hugo Lloris. Hugo had a fantastic penalty save. He also kept a clean sheet, and now his inform has gone to an 89. Next up, we have a game of most likely to. As you can see, Matty and Sean both have cards of themselves. So I'm gonna ask them a series of questions, and then they're gonna pick who's more likely to do what. Okay, the first one up, guys, is which one of you is most likely to cook dinner? So you both have gone with Sean.
I wouldn't trust him cooking anything, so I'd say me.
Can you not cook?
Nah, I took food tech, so I've got a mince pie in the locker from scratch. Mince pie from scratch I can make.
So that's your party piece, you can put on. What do you like to cook? Any go-to dishes?
Not really. Pasta, chicken really before a game, that's about it to be fair.
Who is most likely to forget the other's birthday? Again, you both agreed, both gone with you, Sean.
Although I'd never forget his birthday.
Who's most likely to turn up late? So who's timekeeping? Are you often late?
I'm not normally late, but he is just ridiculously early. If we were to be in a game for 12 o'clock, he'll get there at 10 o'clock. It's like ridiculous. So.
It's good habits.
Exactly, yeah. It is.
Who's more likely to win a FIFA 20? Wow. Again, you agree. That's 4 out of 4. So obviously, Sean is better at FIFA, but how did it feel being, like, seeing yourself in the game?
My little cousin who loves FIFA, he sent us the kind of photo of it, of comparing the two and
of your item. Yeah.
So his stats are better than mine, so obviously.
I believe, yeah, you're get on a 62 bronze rated. Yeah, if I'm correct.
Hopefully I'll work my way up.
Who has the better banter? Like, you both just keep agreeing with one another. So obviously you both come with Matty. What makes his banter so good?
I think he's pretty quick-witted, to be fair. Like, if someone says something to him, he'll have a response in a matter of seconds normally. And I think he's laughing, his smile normally makes probably some of the stuff he says a little bit funnier.
Who makes the better cup of tea?
I go on.
Again, both
agreed again.
Agree, yeah. That's six in a row, quite impressive.
Yeah. Yeah. He drinks a lot of it, so he's making it all the time.
Do you not make a good cup of tea, no?
Nah, I don't tend to drink it. Unless I'm going to make one for my mum in the house, I'm not making one.
Just wait for your brother to make it.
I like it, I like it.
Who's more lazy around the house? Incredible. Both agree again.
Did you see me?
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
He's just as messy as I am, but I think my mum used to get angry at me. So he used to be better at hiding it all. He used to throw it in the cupboards and she'd think, oh, his room's pretty tidy, man. She used to leave it on the floor and I wasn't really that bothered.
Yeah, fair enough. Who's the biggest diva?
There's only one winner right here. There's only one winner.
Why are you laughing so much?
If there's something to complain about, I'll probably complain about it. He does a better job of just being quiet.
Who's most likely to become Newcastle captain? Finally! We have a question you disagree on. You both say one another.
Everything he does on and off the pitch is unbelievable for him being a 19-year-old kid. Obviously, we're brothers, so I'll be biased, but it's true in terms of in the gym, whether it's what he's eating, all that stuff off the pitch, and then on it, you see how committed he is. Gets around, tackles people, gets on people at 19, and he just shows all the qualities that a great leader sort of has, so that's why I would say him.
What about you, Matty? What do you think of your older brother?
Obviously, he's a hard worker, but I think you see how talented he is, and I think he can become the captain by showing, setting an example on the ball and stuff. It's not always the other way around for a captain. I think he's got a bit of both in him, so I think hopefully in the future he can be a captain for the home club.
Yeah, you never know. You could be captain and vice captain.
Be good.
Got a good captain here at the minute, though, so hopefully he doesn't go anywhere.
Next up is Yerry Mina, who scored two goals in injury time in the first half against Watford. Two incredible headers. He's had a massive upgrade. He's gone from 78 to 84. He's the centre-back you would like in your team. Next up, we have ultimate teammate. So basically, there's six attributes. You've got pace, passing, dribbling, defending, shooting, and physical. So I want you to try and build a perfect player from Premier League history. So we'll start with shooting.
Got to be the top goal scorer, doesn't it, and of all time?
Especially being from Newcastle, I think it has to be Shearer, I think.
260 Premier League goals.
Drops for Shearer! Oh!
Next one up, dribbling.
We'll go for Ronaldo. He's probably someone pretty good to pick. You could probably pick him for every single category, but...
Well, I don't know about defending. We'll get to defending eventually.
Now we'll go Ronaldo.
Next up, pace.
Should we keep it local for this one?
Got to go DeAndre in it.
We'll go with Yed. Newcastle, we'll stay with Yed.
Is he the fastest in your team?
There's a few quick ones. Max, he's pretty quick as well.
Obviously, we've got Kieran Clark sitting over there. Would you say Clarky?
Clarky's up there, but like we said about Ronaldo, we could do the same for Clarky and give him everything. So we'll give this one to Yed.
Next up, we'll go with passing.
Gerard Rooney scores. They'd probably be my top three.
Watching scores, it was just with the easy sort of done it. It looked like he wasn't even kicking the ball properly, and it was just perfect pretty much every time. So for me, I'd say scores.
Right, the next up is defending.
Kieran Clark again.
Kieran Clark, he's
up there. I think you've probably got Van Dijk, who's up there with one of the...
Probably him and Terry, I would say. No.
And Rio Ferdinand as well. Probably throw Vidic in there as well. So there's a few names, but if you look how sort of dominant Liverpool are at the moment, and a lot of that has been since Van Dijk's came in.
The last one is physical.
Traore, I think.
That's a damn of Traore, of course.
Strongest player I've ever played against. Tried to get near him a few times and you just can't move him.
It's funny, I think there's a time he's running through the middle and me and Matty are on both sides of him, trying to pull him back, and he's just sort of like batting off like we're two 10-year-olds.
Did you know Adama Traore doesn't actually lift weights?
Yeah, I've seen something about that. Absolutely mental. Absolutely mental.
I'm not going to lie, I wish I had that problem, but unfortunately not.
Bob, Now I want you to rate your player out of 99.
There's no perfect scores.
You can't get a perfect score.
So yeah, I think you've got to go 100.
We'll go 98.
There's always something to beat of the 98, and it's the one coming up.
The third player in Team of the Week from the Premier League is Robert Snodgrass. Snodgrass scored two impressive goals against Brighton. Snodgrass has had a +5 to his now new inform, which is 81 rated. So then guys, Sean and Matty are going to take on the Red Cup Challenge. Now usually what we do is they will build a pyramid and we will time them. But since they're two brothers, we want to see who can build a pyramid faster between the two boys. So lads, in front of you, you both got 21 cups. What I want you to do is build a little pyramid with 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1, go. Do you want, Matty's got fierce technique going on here. He's got the little head motion going.
Yeah, a bit of fake going.
Oh, I think it's over already, isn't it?
I can't believe you beat me at this, you know.
You are terrible at this.
Not my game. The cup's stuck in my, not my game.
Do you want to go again? For pride?
Oh, well, then I'm going to have to let him win if I go again, though. You've met me the big brother and set an example, aren't you?
The fourth and final Premier League player in Team of the Week is none other than Roberto Firmino. Now, he had 3 assists. He's one of 4 players to ever do that in Premier League. Let me know in the comment section down below if Roberto Firmino is going into your team. Right then guys, we are in the Uncut van. Sean and Matty are about to play a game of FIFA. As you can see on screen, they're both Newcastle. Matty, you are in the home kit. Sean, you are in the away kit. Oh, here comes John Joe bursting through.
Block it, block it.
Oh.
Matty,
you look a lot taller in game.
I just gotta say, Sean looks like he's got a caravan on his back.
What, in a real game or just in this?
Oh, he's in, he's in. Sean!
He's only scored it himself.
Oh, Sean Longstaff makes it 1-0 with you. Oh, look at the celebration.
It's actually me who's passed it as well, look.
He's couldn't play this, the opposition. Finishing off!
He hasn't, has he?
Oh, has he made it? What's the celebration this time?
It's him again.
That's poor from you, man.
It is half-time. Matty, you are 2-0 down. It's a Longstaff double, but it's a double with your brother.
Get on it. Get on it. Matty! Oh! That's good.
Oh. Game's gone dead.
Oh, he's trying very hard to get a hat-trick on himself. Miggy! Oh. Oh.
Just pass that in.
Yeah, just pass it.
Should have scored there.
Referee! Oh, he's in. Almiron! He's pulled it wide.
He's got to hit the target.
You've got to hit the target there.
Who's he missed?
Well, I don't think you can blame him. I think you've got to blame yourself.
Look at Bailey.
Should have been on earlier. Go on, Bales.
56 rated. Probably left him down at that point.
Go on then, Yedlin.
Well, here he goes.
Yedlin stands it up at the back post. Oh, Jordan.
Second balls. After this half
clearance. Oh, it's a good effort, that. Last 10 minutes here, Matty. You need a big push.
I need something.
You do. Oh, just zipping the ball out to Brother.
Oh, I love that.
Zipping it out to Richie. Skipping by players.
Oh, referee.
Referee. That's what slapping us in the head on Tuesday night.
Go, here we go.
Matty Longstaff.
Oh, what a pass, Matty. Now run.
I don't think your manager would pick me if you keep backing on the ball like that.
Room for the cross.
Here we go.
Oh, poor.
Oh, the edge is on
skipping,
fire.
He's skipping by people.
Oh,
there we have it.
Thank you.
Had chances as well, that's a missed chances killed his air.
Sean, 2-0, comfortable.
Comfortable away performance, really.
So Sean Longstaff scores 2 goals to Sean Longstaff to beat Matty Longstaff.
Yeah.
Well, there you have it, guys. A big thank you to Matty and Sean Longstaff for having us here today, and of course, Newcastle for inviting us down. So anyway, boys, make sure to like and subscribe and comment down below.